What was it the Austrian newspaper wrote? Any man who says he will travel to the North Pole and back in a balloon is either a simpleton, a charlatan, or a Swede. How well we qualified! Young Strindberg, a latter-day Don Quixote, risked his life to impress the blue-eyed goddess of his dreams. Throughout the journey, he wrote her love letters. But where did he expect to post them, I wonder? Our leader, Andre, dreamt only of glory and immortality, already photographed and measured for his waxwork likeness, which would stand in some dusty museum. Its translucent finger pointing to this journal I now hold in my freezing hand. And I, Frankel, I measured the winds, and I plotted the stars, and asked myself over and over again, what attracted me to the north, like the trembling needle of a said that we should. I answered, I think we ought to try it. Andre was serious and said nothing. Now my thoughts turn to you and to my parents and friends at home. Journey succeed, and how fast my thoughts came, cut away everywhere, come Andre's voice, three knives cut the three lines, and the balloon arises, rises amid the jeers of those indeed. blackbird circles a moment in the distance, then disappears in the fog. The sun has gone. Good night. It is not a little strange to be floating here above the polar sea. To be the first that has floated here in a balloon. I cannot deny that all three of us are dominated by a feeling of pride. We think we can well face death, having done what we have done. Isn't it all perhaps expression of an extremely strong sense of individuality, which cannot bear the thought of living and dying like a man in the ranks, forgotten by coming generations? Is this ambition? Dispatched July 11, 1897, four carrier pigeons sent off. We are now in over the ice, which is much divided in every direction. Weather magnificent, best of humor. By the a steady fine drizzle had deposited more than a ton of ice above our heads. On the webbing that encircles the balloon, became seasick and vomited that excellent dinner, while Andre glared at the fog, attempting to will the enshrouded sun to appear and and so I suppose there. jumped out of the balloon. Worn out and famished. But determined to set out from the point where we now are. Well, neither Niels knows what it is to walk on polar ice. We had a little mishap at the start. While crossing from one ice floe to the next, the first sledge went crooked and fell in. Jumped down into the water and held fast the sledge so that it should not sink. It was with difficulty it was saved. Andre was angry that I had taken such a risk. Since we have two more sledges and provisions enough. Of course, he did not know that in the first sledge is my sack with all your letters and your I should write about, but now I must sleep. Good night. Thank you. It is hard to believe that Jubilee Day was scarcely a month ago. An observer might have found our patriotic display pathetic. Strindberg was bandaged all over for cuts and boils. My feet were useless and I could no longer pull my sledge. All three of us suffered from cracked lips, a permanent catarrh, noses running constantly, attacks of diarrhea and cramps. The good Dr. Andre prescribed morphine and opium tablets. We rested, then marched a few more kilometers. More morphine and opium, a few more kilometers. Drugs would last. The day has been extremely beautiful. Perhaps the most beautiful.
Thank you.
Built our winter house of ice and snow. Andre christened it home. A week later, I buried Strindberg, and I fashioned a crude black mourning ribbon to adorn my coat. Poor Andre, unaware that Strindberg had died, that he himself was dying, continued to babble on and on about the next expedition, and filled a few more pages in his notebooks. Before long, there bloomed a second ribbon. Next will come my turn, and then it all will be concluded. It is clear to me now that Andre knew from the start that our journey was doomed. And I think I understand what made him persevere to the end. In the years to come, when our frozen bodies have been found, and returned home to Sweden, the bright, elusive glory he sought will be his. Attracted me to the north, like the trembling needle of a compass. Drift away.